You're still with Eton and we're chatting with Kareena Kapoor. But before we get back to her, we take a quick look at her career graph.
Her last film may have been a box office disaster, but Kareena Kapoor has no reason to be down at all. She's on a roll promoting two of the most talked about films of the year, Kurban and Three Idiots. That's the story of Bebo. You can't keep her down for long. After turning down Hrithik Roshan's launchpad Kaho Na Pyar Hai, Kareena debuted with JP Dutta's Refugee in 2000, which was shot dead at the box office. That was soon followed by surprise hit Mujhe Kuch Kehna Hai, and then a series of flops like Dev, Jeena Sirf Mere Liye, Bewafa and Ashoka.
I think initially she kind of made a few errors in the middle part of her career, 2002 to 2005. I think those 2-3 years she made a lot of mistakes. But now I think in the last 3 years she has really been very selective and done the right kinds of films.
After starring in big banner flops like Raj Shree's Main Prem Ki Diwani Hoon, Mukta Art's Yaade and Yash Raj's Mujhse Dosti Karogi, Kareena experimented with her choice of roles and banners. Then came Chameli, Yuva and Omkara, films that established her as a performer. Kareena's paycheck went from 75 lakhs to 1.5 crore rupees. And her open declaration of love for Shahid Kapoor kept her in the limelight constantly. Not that she needed rescuing, but it wasn't Shahid Kapoor, but Imtiaz Ali who arrived as her knight in shining armour. Jab We Met was a film of a lifetime.
Thank you, Baba Ji.
When we were almost done with the shooting in Shimla, there was a day when I actually told her that, Kareena, you have a reputation of being badly behaved on set and of coming late and misbehaving and all of that, not listening. So, but you have disappointed me right through the shooting of the movie by never really misbehaving. So why don't you at least for once come late?
And it's never too late for an image makeover. Dashan fell flat at the box office but gave Kareena her size zero style icon reputation. The film also gave her a new relationship with Saif Ali Khan. With the new tag came Kareena's new fee, 3 crore rupees for a film. The style icon tag was etched further with the release of Kambakht Ishq. Kareena's choice of the movie was bashed, but her clothes and shoes were objects of awe.
I've shot so many newcomers, but she didn't feel like a newcomer. I felt I'm already shooting a star. Right in her first photo shoot, you know, like I said, she used to come for Lolo shooting, she used to take keen interest, so she exactly knew how to move.
The looks and the panache make Bebo a desired ambassador for an array of brands. Her latest endorsement, of course, is Sony Bio's new laptop that actually goes by the size zero tagline. Bebo rakes in 5 crore rupees per endorsement, but if it's with Bose Saif, be willing to pay a concessional price of 6 to 7 crore rupees. In 2009 alone, Ms. Kapoor's piggy bank had over 40 crore rupees stashed away. No surprises then that Kareena's upcoming slate of movies reads like the dream of any heroine worth her salt. Comic caper Three Idiots, emotional drama Stepmom and thriller Agent Vinod. Kareena's got a mixed bag just like her checkered career.
Probably there was just this one phase in your career that, you know, was not too good and there were a lot of flops. What were your learnings really from that phase?
I think just to believe in yourself. That's what's really important, is to believe in yourself and your dreams and work hard. I think in everybody's career, if you don't take risks, then that high doesn't happen. You have to learn to break out from the typical, you know, stereotype images. And try to break away and do something different completely. And I've loved doing that, whether it was Chameli or if it was Dev or if it was Omkara. Or even now, I mean, you know, like playing a glamorous girl in Kambakht Ishq. Or now Kurban, I mean, doing an intense, gritty role like that. I mean, I love doing it. I like to do different things.
There was a time when, you know, Tashan was being trashed for the way it was, or Kambakht Ishq, you know, people were criticizing the fact that, you know, somebody like you who's supposed to be a thinking actress has done that role.
But I'm not a thinking actress.
No, but you know, we definitely look at Kareena as somebody who, okay, at the same time, Omkara, but there's also a gold mall, as you said.
Like I said, that, you know, it's so important to strike a balance between every role that you do. It is really important to do that. You can't only keep doing films like, I can't keep doing films like Dev and Chameli and films like that. I also need to strike a balance and, you know, I mean, films like Golmaal and Kambhakti should be watched for what they actually are. I mean, I don't think anybody was really looking for a script or a story in it. I mean, it's more for the style and, you know, just to watch it for whatever it is. And not every movie is rocket science. And there will be some great films where there will be great scripts online, like Kurban and Three Idiots. But I mean, I also enjoy acting in fun movies, yeah? And I should be able to strike a balance between everything.
You know, there's a point of time when people were like, okay, what you remember most now after Kambhak Ishq is the way the Kareena
clothes.
Looked in the
I'm
movie.
I'm glad
the
because there was not really anything else that was there, and it was not really publicized as that kind of movie that you have to remember what the story was. It was clearly publicized as a film, which was the most stylized film of the year. And I think the clothes and shoes were anyway being publicized more than the story. So people should not forget that.
When did you realize that, you know, probably that visualization, you know, Kareena Kapoor, the look is as important as a well-written role?
I think more so in the last 5 years. You know, all actors are kind of, I mean, like Aamir and Shah Rukh or Saif, everybody are, you know, kind of more aware and conscious of their looks now in their movies and the way they're looking. So I'm equally conscious of what we're supposed to do now in movies, because 50% of your character is also the way you look, which I do keep in mind now, I think, since the last 5 years.
And Kareena, if we look at you as a brand right now, how would you really define yourself, you know, through your endorsements?
Basically, the fact that what I obviously also believe in, I mean, I don't endorse alcohol and smoking and tobacco and non-vegetarian food, because these are three things that I don't believe in. Because I'm a strict vegetarian, I'm a teetotaler, and I'm against smoking. So these are the three things I keep in mind before I tend to do anything. I mean, if I'm going to be offered to endorse a non-vegetarian burger in McDonald's, I'm not going to do it, even if I'm offered 20 crores, because I don't believe in it.
Size zero actually is a thing of the past. It was something that was talked about earlier, but that somehow seems to have really associated itself with Kareena Kapoor.
Yeah, size zero has like become an international topic now. It's like the Sensex. Yeah, I mean, Sony Vaio wanted to launch a laptop which is more like sleek and slim and sexy and chic. So they've named it the new size zero, because if you see, the laptop is like a clutch bag. Somewhere, I think Sony International, which is one of the biggest brands in the world, I think it's a great honor for me that they've actually launched a laptop in my name.
So you're completely cool with the fact that that's going to be associated with you, I think, lifelong. That's something that came around in...
It's definitely going to be a big chapter in my book after 20 years, I see. But at least some Indian actors started it.
And Kareena, you know, you're at this stage in your career when, you know, roles are being written where you're penciled and you're being kept in mind. So do you feel that, you know, yes, you have a plumb variety of roles available, but do you feel there are things that have not been written as yet, you know, for which you have so much more scope?
Well, I mean, I would like to act in films like Revolutionary Road and The Reader, but, you know, unfortunately, those kind of movies don't get made in India. So whatever comes, I'm sure, is the best. Kurban and Three Idiots are the best films this year. I firmly believe that, even if I was not a part of it. I think they're both great cinema and both dramatically different. And I'm just lucky to be a part of it.
Coming up on the other side, experience the nuances of rural Indian games online and get set for the musical bonanza coming your way this weekend.